What is up, guys? Today we're going to take a look at how to do the censor effect inside iMovie. This is actually one that I've been asked about a lot. First things first, though, before we get started, like with most iMovie effects, you need to make sure you have advanced tools turned on. So go to preferences, and then under preferences, go ahead and make sure you have the advanced tools box checked right there. Otherwise, none of these methods are going to actually work for you. All right, now that that's taken care of, let's go ahead and get started with our effect. Now, what I have here is just some pretty old footage of me talking, and what we're going to do is censor my face. And the first technique we're going to use is the very basic one, and that's just applying a black box over it. So what you see here is just a simple black box PNG. I'm going to go ahead and take it and then drag it into my footage onto the timeline itself. And when I let go, since I have advanced tools turned on, you see I get picture in picture. I'll select that. And now I get this nice black box that I can move around the screen and resize as appropriate and put it over whatever I want to censor out. So this is a pretty basic method, but let's say you want to do something more advanced. And that's usually what people think of when they think of censoring, is that kind of pixelated effect you see in a lot of videos. So let's go ahead and see how you can accomplish that using only iMovie. Our first step is going to be exporting our footage that we want the censor effect applied to. And I know that seems kind of counterintuitive, but just stick with me for a couple steps and you'll see why we do that. So under Share, go ahead and select Export Using QuickTime, not Export Movie. And what that's going to do is give us a lot of different options on how our footage is exported. So under Options, I'm going to go and select Size. And now the smaller you make these numbers, the more pixelated your final image is going to look. So for mine, I'm going to do 75 by 75. You can really just experiment and see what works best for you and your project. Go ahead, hit OK on all this, and just export our footage out. As this is exporting, this is a good time to mention, as with all of my effects tutorial videos, this is really meant to more show you the technique and not really a finished product. So the key to making this look good is you really kind of experimenting with what settings really work well with your footage and the project you're working on. So here's our footage that's been exported, and you can see it's a very tiny, tiny file-sized copy of what we're looking at in iMovie. So what we're going to do is go ahead and import that into iMovie so we can actually use it as our censor effect. So go to File, Import, Movie, and then we'll go ahead and select our clip from our desktop. All right, now that that is imported into iMovie, we can take it down to our timeline, and once again, we're going to select Picture in Picture like we did before. And now you can see we have basically a low-res copy of our original footage. And what you want to do is, this is where the audio waveforms really come in handy. So line up the audio tracks, and then that's really going to make your picture in sync as well. So you don't have to worry about that in the future. Now I'm going to select crop on our pixelated image that was in our picture-in-picture portion. And I'm going to move it around to whatever portion of the video I want to censor. So in this case, we're going to go for my face, but of course we could have censored the shirt or the background or anything else we wanted. So I'll just kind of make some fine-tune adjustments on this. And then when I go ahead and hit done, you can see that now there's a pixelated copy of my face sitting over there. Now here's where the really finessing work comes in. You can spend a lot of time to kind of match this up as perfectly or as imperfectly as you want. And really, once again, it all comes down to your style and what the goals of your project are. So there you guys have it, two ways to do the censor effect in iMovie. Of course, I've got plenty of other videos on iMovie. If you're interested in this sort of thing, you can check them out on my channel. As always, thanks a lot for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.